My name is Julia. I want to tell you my story about a choice. When I had to choose between love and life, I chose life. A lot of people condemn me for this. My story is no different from thousands of others. I met Max at school. He joined our class in 7th grade. His family moved to our neighborhood from the other side of our town. And immediately, he started showing me some attention. A nerdy girl and a bad boy didn't have much in common. He had quite a special romantic way to gain my attention. He would take away my school bag or put chewing gum in my hair and stuff. I really hated Max until we were in 11th grade. I called him Mr. Too. Too active, too loud, too ill-mannered. I even wanted to transfer to another class because of his attitude towards me. His actions felt more like bullying. But one day at school, we had a Valentine's Day dance. He gave me a bouquet of flowers and confessed his feelings. I hit him with the flowers, thinking he was mocking me again. But it turned out, he truly loved me. For me, I was hitting puberty and wanted to rebel. That's how our relationship started. My parents were totally against it. He didn't have a dad, and already had a long juvenile criminal record. My parents didn't think he was good for me. Max tried to teach me bad things. Riding a motorcycle, buying cheap alcohol and cigarettes and stuff. He always said he loved that I was so well-mannered all the time, acting like a human. His understanding of a human was totally different than the rest of the world. Sometimes I would even agree to his adventures. It was mainly because I loved him. I was really surprised to find out I was truly in love with him. Max was not the type of guy my parents liked. It made me like him even more. I didn't really obey him. I was in no hurry. I had my own goals in life. I wanted to enter the university, to obtain a degree in a foreign language, and participate in horseback riding championships. Max didn't like the fact that my goals kept me away from spending all my time with him, but I made him face the fact that it was this or nothing. He got cooler with age. He even began to think about our future. He said he wanted a lot of kids and a big house. He even found a part-time job and started saving money for college. He wanted to study in the same city where I was supposed to go. At our prom, he proposed to me. He was on one knee with a ring. I promised to think about it. My mom got hysterical and planned to send me to study abroad, away from this criminal element. But then she calmed down, understanding we wouldn't be getting married tomorrow. Then I started college. We moved to another city. Max rented us an apartment. He earned money at a car care center. He was quite a good mechanic. He also took part in motorcycle racing. I invested in our family budget for my scholarship. I never asked him for anything. I'm not like that. I don't cry for cool things or gifts from guys like other girls do. I knew how hard it was for him to earn money. I sometimes even refused his insistent offers to buy me something. We lived like this for a year, just like a husband and wife. My parents had accepted the fact that I had such an inappropriate love. Max proved himself to be a model husband, but then a tragedy happened. Max often participated in illegal motorcycle races. He was a real pro, so he got a lot of money just for participating. If he won, the amount tripled. I tried to convince him that it was dangerous and good health was more important, but he wouldn't listen. One day, his friends told me he missed a turn. The guys from his team studied what was left of his motorcycle after the accident. They wanted to go to the police with what they found. The brake hose had been cut, but later, they were all threatened. Another team said if this story went to the police, the same thing would probably happen to them or to their loved ones. It didn't really matter, because Max was in a coma in the hospital. I wish he'd stayed in a coma, because when he came out, he was like a vegetable. He could barely move his eyes and his right-hand fingers. The rest of his body was paralyzed because of multiple spine fractures. At 18, I was left with a disabled person who was paralyzed. His mom and I tried hard to rehabilitate him for about 6 months, but it was no use. The doctors refused to make any speculations. They said, with his injuries, he definitely had to stay in bed for another 10 years. There was no hope he would ever get up. I gave up my studies, and we took turns caring for him. But I gave up 6 months later. I'm 18. I have good prospects in life. Maybe I can even be successful. I didn't want to spend all my life on a half-dead body, even if it was once someone I loved. Max himself didn't recognize anyone and couldn't communicate. Sometimes, he just shouted nonsense. I didn't have to explain my choice to him. His mother understood. I don't know if she forgave me, but at least she sent me home with a sincere wish of good luck. I went back to my studies and now I live a normal life. Next year, I will transfer to a foreign university on a paid scholarship. I still have a lot of interesting things waiting for me, but I have no friends. When people know my story, they all condemn me for leaving a disabled person. When I asked one of them what she would do in such a situation, she couldn't give me an answer. Don't condemn people if you haven't been in their shoes. Write in the comments what you would do in such a situation. And always try to understand where someone is coming from before expressing your opinion.